Students, I am here again with a modern concept of physics, dual nature of matter and radiation. We already know about the wave nature of light as exhibited by the phenomena like interference, diffraction and polarization. But under certain conditions, light, which is electromagnetic radiation, is found to be consisting of a bunch of particles called photons. Thus, we can say that light or radiation display particle nature also, and that is exhibited by the phenomena like photoelectric effect and Compton effect, which involve transfer of energy and momentum. Naturally, the question comes in mind, if radiation behaves both as wave and as particle, then matter should also behave the same way. The answer was provided by the French physicist Louis de Broglie, who gave the concept of wave-particle duality, which is called de Broglie hypothesis. The name is written Broglie, but it is pronounced as Broglie. We know that electron is a particle. It has discrete mass and moves with definite speed. Sometimes it displays wave nature also, which is supported by the experimental observation of electron diffraction. Hence, it was found that matter has also dual nature. So, matter and wave both have dual nature. But they exhibit only one nature at a time, not both at the same time. According to Planck's quantum theory, a source of radiation emits energy in the form of photons. Photons are packets of energy emitted by the source of radiation, and they travel along the straight line with the speed of light. Besides this feature, let us see some more characteristics of photons. The energy of a photon is E is equal to h nu or equal to hc by lambda, where h is the Planck's constant and it has the value 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. Nu and lambda are the frequency and wavelength of photon and c is the speed of radiation. All photons emitted from a source of radiation travel with the same speed, that is the speed of light. Frequency gives the radiation a definite energy and hence a definite color, which does not change when photon travels through different media. It means frequency of radiation does not change and remains constant. When photon moves in different media, its velocity changes due to change in the wavelength. The mass m of a particle moving with velocity v comparable with the velocity of light c is given by m is equal to m naught divided by under root 1 minus v square by c square, where m naught is the rest mass of the particle, and therefore m naught is equal to m times under root 1 minus v square by c square. Here, as photon moves with velocity of light, that is v is equal to c, then m naught is equal to 0. It indicates that photon has zero rest mass, which means photons do not exist at rest. As we know, E is equal to mc square, and also it is equal to h nu. So, the equivalent mass m of a photon of frequency nu is given by m is equal to h nu by c square. And momentum of the photon is therefore mc is equal to h nu by c. As c by nu is equal to lambda, therefore momentum p is equal to h by lambda. The energy of a photon is usually expressed in electron volt, and 1 electron volt is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. Photons are electrically neutral and they are not deflected by electric or magnetic fields. Under suitable conditions, photons show phenomenon of diffraction. So these are some of the characteristics of a photon. De Broglie suggested that the wavelength lambda associated with a particle of momentum p is given as lambda is equal to h by p, which is also equal to h by mv. This is known as the De Broglie relation, where wavelength lambda of the matter wave is called Broglie wavelength. M is the mass of the particle and v is its speed. In the relation, we see that wavelength lambda is the attribute or property of a wave, while the momentum p is an attribute of a particle. And the Planck's constant actually relates the two attributes. We have already seen that for a photon, p is equal to h by lambda, so that lambda is equal to h by p. And this is De Broglie relation, which is same for both radiations and particles. For any heavy particle which we see around us in our day-to-day life, the De Broglie wavelength is not measurable. We can calculate the De Broglie wavelength of an object of mass 0.1 kg moving with a speed of about 20 meters per second, which comes out equal to 3.313 into 10 to the power minus 34 meter. You can calculate this using De Broglie relation, lambda is equal to h by p or lambda is equal to h by mv. You can see how small is this value. We cannot measure such a small length, and that is why we cannot see the macroscopic objects showing wave-like properties. On the other hand, for microscopic particles like an electron, which has mass 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg and charge 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, being accelerated through a potential v, the De Broglie wavelength comes out to be 1.227 by under root v nanometer. This value is measurable. Hence, wave nature displayed by microscopic particles can be seen using proper instruments and also by conducting crystal diffraction experiment. The wave nature of electron was established experimentally by Davisson and Germer in 1927. As you can see in the diagram, the apparatus consists of an electron gun in which there is a filament F of tungsten coated with barium oxide, which is heated with current from low tension battery. Filament emits large number of electrons which are accelerated applying suitable potential from high voltage power supply to the cylinder A with fine holes along the axis, which collimates the beam of electrons. From electron gun, the fine collimated beam falls normally on the nickel crystal N and are scattered in different directions. The intensity of a scattered beam is detected by electron detector D, rotating it on a circular scale at different positions at different scattering angles theta. A sensitive galvanometer is connected to the detector to measure the current, which is proportional to the intensity of electron beam. By recording intensity of electron beam at different positions, the variation of intensity I of the scattered beam of electrons with angle of scattering theta for different accelerating voltages between 44 volt to 68 volt are obtained. The observations show a strong peak in intensity I for a voltage of 54 volt at a scattering angle theta is equal to 50 degree, which is due to constructive interference of electrons scattered from different layers of the regularly spaced atoms of the crystal. From measurement, the wavelength is found to be 0.165 nanometer. The de Broglie wavelength lambda for electron, which we found lambda is equal to 1.227 by under root V nanometer, with V is equal to 54 volt, lambda comes out equal to 0.167 nanometer, which is in agreement with the experimental value. Hence, we can say that the Davisson-Germer experiment confirms the wave nature of electrons and the de Broglie relation. The de Broglie hypothesis have provided base for the development of the modern quantum mechanics. It has also led to the field of electron optics. The wave properties of electrons have been used for designing electron microscope, which has a very high resolution. Okay, this much for now. In the next meet, photoelectric effect will be discussed, which suggested the particle nature of light. See you soon.